We are go here in the Belgian Grand Prix. This is round three of Cobalt, and let's go. Umad Bro is flown up through the field already in this race. Fantastic stuff there from Umad Bro. He's on three positions already. Yellow flags in a sector one then. And what has occurred there? There's some cars going around then. Bulky's in the middle. And Irvine takes the lead. Second position is Jinnah. Third position is Hammer Time. Jones is off. He's off the circuit. He's had a great start to the championship, but he's off the track. Oh, that's not good at all. Has he damaged the car? No, he hasn't then. And Bulky just sneaks by. And oh, goodness me, Picasso from a long way back there. And oh, goodness me, they're almost going to the side of that Red Bull. And that was very well controlled there from Picasso. Impressive stuff indeed. Cosmo coming across the line. Oh, look at, oh, my goodness me, there's cars all over the show here. That one completed. The gap is at 0.9 seconds. And here at the start of the Belgian Grand Prix, there's a car into the back. Then Foles, he's got into the back. He's damaged the McLaren. There's amount of damage on this circuit with the amount of turning you need. Then it's, oh, Ferrari's off. Vinny is off the circuit. He is gone. He's gone in a big way. He's still spinning around there. That's a humongous smash. It's a virtual safety car. Bordeaux with Starbus, and he's not. Oh my goodness me, he's having a go. Blanchard? He is. He is. And there's Duncan as well then. And look at this. And he is flying past there. And Kaz is struggling. He is struggling there. And look at Duncan. He's on the outside as well. And ZGS has got past Picasso. We've got DRS enabled at the end of the third lap. Foxy's retired. It's a safety car. It's a safety car. Foxy has gone off at the top of the hill. And it is a first safety car tonight then. And it was a shame for Foxy there. He was living in cloud nine at the start of this race. After only four laps, he is out of the Grand Prix. Irvine is, oh my goodness me, and a Duncan there as Fidel, not sure if he was defending or whatnot, but Duncan there into the corner of no name. That's very unusual. I think that Irvine needs to get the job done quite pronto here. Yellow flags then, as we have got Starburst is off it. Poo Young as well. He comes back on the circuit, and Starburst, then who's second in the world championship, dropping down the order just too far back then. But look at this, Hammer Time on the outside. He's on the outside, but Jinnah is not yielding. Irvine's on the outside as well, and Irvine might have done it, but Duncan is not yielding either. This is great racing. This is great racing. Motor racing at its best. Oh, magnificent stuff there on those soft compound tires, and Hammer Time is all over the gearbox of the McLaren. He is alongside the McLaren. He is past the McLaren. He moves up into second position. Job done. 2.2 seconds. Remember that gap, because now he's got to really try and reel that down. Can he do it then? As Diashi is still on the start tires, which he has started this race on then. He has spun the rear tires. And look at this. And now on the inside, Jose goes. And that's a very much a day late and a dollar short there. It was a lunge. Duncan there just watched his rival go by. And he was back through them very calmly like there from the Williams tire. Vinny and Jim Straff there. Jim Straff. Oh, there's contact there. There's contact with the Ferrari and the Haas car. Ooh, Jim Straff is actually driving the Williams tonight. He's just a... oh, no. And that's a day late and a dollar short there from Vinny. And he has spun it. And I think that was a desperation move there, wasn't it? Unfortunately for the Ferrari driver. Duncan has dropped down the order then. Where is he? Oh no! And look, he's in the wall! He's in the wall! And we've had contact at the top of the hill. And Duncan there, who's had a magnificent debut here in ALR Cobalt. And all his hard work is coming to nothing now. The scary part of the circuit when you're on slick tires on a damp track. Diashi there is harvested. He can sense it. DRS has been disabled then. I think in his time, as Kaz is now in trouble, and he's out of the race, and the Fania chicane, and there's a safety car. They're all in the pit. How unlucky was Hammer Time there? He was going for the race lead, and then the safety car came out just at the wrong time there. Board that Irvine just in front of us at the moment. He's gone wide into Blanchimont then, as a yellow flag in free. Iron Knight is off. He is off in a big way. Look, there's Devereaux across the circuit there. Iron Knight is out of the Grand Prix. Oh my goodness me. Duncan is through. He is, oh no, Scooby Stew is off, and he's come back on the track there. Scooby Stew has that. Oh, what a shame for Scooby Stew on the final lap out of the final turn. And Diashi, for the first time in his ALR career, wins the ALR Grand Prix. He wins the Belgian Grand Prix in appalling conditions there. Diashi is a Grand Prix winner in ALR. Diashi, his first ever Grand Prix win in ALR. Fantastic performance there from Diashi, and how he kept his head there and in his first ever race win is beyond me. Magnificent stuff. He has shown some metal tonight, hasn't he? Umad Bro once again there, showing that he's got consistency as the key there, and this is the third race in a row he has been in the points. And good stuff from Umad Bro. Hammer Time in fourth, Hammer Time third, Irvine fourth, Starbus fifth, Yossi sixth, Jinnah seventh, Duncan eighth, Jim Straff ninth, 10th position Cosmo, ZGS 11, Stars 12, Vinny 13, Bulky 14, Scooby Stew is retirements in 50 position. Sorry, Scuba Shoe 50. Retirements, Iron Knight, Kaz, Liam D, Picasso, and Foxy.